Happy Monday, everyone. Thank you for your company this morning. A big welcome to our wonderful guest panellist today, Simon Kennedy. Yay! You excited?
I'm so excited. Summer's here.
I know.
I can feel it.
Is it a pinch?
A punch. And, you know, wear some shorts, especially if you're a police officer in Queensland. Get some shorts on. It's lovely.
There's lots to chat about today, so let's get started. Half of the Victorians who voted against the coalition on Saturday say the Abbott government was a key factor in their vote. And that certainly has Queensland's Newman government concerned. Queenslanders will go to their state election no later than June, and News Corp newspapers reporting state coalition MPs are desperate for Prime Minister Tony Abbott to sort out the federal budget mess, because if not, they'll be punished at the ballot box, just like their Victorian counterparts. Joe, really interesting result on the weekend. Do you think the Abbott factor was a big factor?
Definitely, yes. It's always the case. Australian voters, in a lot of ways, are actually quite sensible, and they vote for balance and they vote for moderation.
We're a very sensible
small C. Yeah, we're a very small C conservative electorate. So, by which I mean we're cautious. So, for example, in Victoria, and it's not the first time it's happened in Victoria. In Victoria, Paul Keating scraped through against all expectations in 1993 because just a few months earlier they just elected Jeff Kennett in an absolute landslide, and yet they come back and vote Labor the next time. This is exactly what's happening. It's obviously different with a first-term government in Victoria getting kicked out for the first time, I think, since the 1950s.
So just goes to show. Is Tony Abbott to blame? Is it his fault?
There would be a correction. Even if Tony Abbott was running a very popular, happy government, there would almost certainly be a correction where voters, you know, have to think, well, we've got a Liberal vote government federally, so we'll have a Labor one at state level, and they'll keep each other in check.
Yeah, I think I agree with you, Joe. I think the government in Victoria was in trouble long before Abbott became Prime Minister. Mm-hmm. I think Ted Baillieu, the previous leader, wasn't very effective. Then they had that rebel MP, Jeff Shaw, who caused all sorts of havoc. Yeah. So I think they were on the nose. I think it's the budget that's really the problem here. Mm. And, of course, that is the Prime Minister.
Budget, yeah.
But it's the budget. You know, the fact that they haven't been able to get it through. Joe Hockey tries very hard, but he's not getting the message across. And I think the poll shows that it was the budget that really turned everybody.
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's the budget.
Abbott is definitely blaming.
But they had difficulties long before Mr Abbott became the Prime Minister. And I can understand why Queensland would feel very anxious, because unless the government does get the budget through, or unless it explains to us all why something has to be done or whatever they're going to do, because they seem there's a lot of changing going on at the moment, then I think the Queensland government has every reason to feel worried.
So do you think this pressure, I guess, from the weekend from Victoria, now renewed pressure from Queensland, will force the Abbott government into doing something?
It well could. I think the other thing you've got to remember about Victoria, of course, is that there's no senior Victorian member in the cabinet. You know, Victoria is very underrepresented in this government, in the federal government, and that's very unusual for Victoria because, you know, Victoria was a place where they churned out people of influence.
I mean, the home of Menzies, of course.
Yes, there's nobody like Peter Costello in the current government who was a leading Victorian.
And I think you've got to also bear in mind that that Campbell Newman was treading on toes in Queensland before Tony Abbott came in and started doing the same. So they've had a lot more of this than anyone else has had, so they're probably quite fed up now.
And, of course, remember too, Pauline Hanson has said she's going to be running in the upcoming Queensland election, so I think that's going to also probably divert a lot of people who may have voted for the Libs.
Although, I think the Victorian results indicate that Clive Palmer's pup party is finished.
On the way down.
Yeah, it's on the way down.
Yeah, I think so.